I'm Anne McCartt. I'm Senior Vice President for Research. Our department looks at a wide range of highway safety topics. We look at roadway safety. So we've studied, for example, how effective roundabouts are in reducing crashes. We look at behavior, mostly drivers. How can we modify their behavior to make them safer? And we look at pedestrians. And then finally, we look at vehicle safety features. We've studied side airbags, front airbags, electronic stability control, and looked at how much safer they can keep people by looking at real-world crashes. It's hard to think of an important highway safety issue we haven't studied. We did some of the early research on alcohol, showing how tough laws can make a difference. We did some of the first studies on seatbelts, and the Institute was involved in the first click-it-or-ticket experiment in North Carolina.
You don't have your seatbelt on, do you?
One of the things that makes it interesting to work in our department is we have a wide range of backgrounds, and it allows us to look at multiple dimensions of problems.
My name is Wen Hu, and I am a research transportation engineer. Transportation engineers work to improve traffic movement and safety, and my role at the Institute is to study the effectiveness of these solutions.
My name is Ian Reagan, and I'm a senior research scientist. The type of research that I do is human factor psychology.
Go ahead and back up.
Okay.
In the world of highway safety, that usually means how drivers interact with vehicles.
I'm Eric Teoh. I'm a senior statistician. In general, a statistician looks for patterns in real-world data to answer research questions. For example, the effect of anti-lock braking systems on fatal motorcycle crashes. We use a lot of mathematics and probability theory to do that.
A lot of our research involves looking at our crash databases, but we also have done in-house experimental studies.
This button here, we'd like you to press every time you see a target.
Where we are monitoring drivers on real roads. So we did a study recently looking at vehicles with different headlight systems.
We instrumented a vehicle and placed targets on a road. We wanted to measure if the drivers could see the target sooner in the vehicle with adaptive headlights compared to the same vehicle with fixed ones.
For a department that does so much research, we're pretty small. And what that means is that we often collaborate with researchers at other organizations so that we can expand our expertise. We worked with researchers at MIT, for example.
We worked with MIT's H-Lab to see how demanding and how visually distracting placing a call or entering a destination into a navigation system was while driving.
Your task is to call Frank Scott at work. Begin.
We're interested in looking at whether or not using your voice
call Frank Scott at work
was less distracting than using your hands.
What I love about doing research at the Institute is that we use such a variety of methods. That makes life very interesting. Our research in child safety illustrates the variety of ways we look at an issue.
The Institute has been doing research in child passenger safety for decades. For example, we've documented the importance of using child restraints, examined the benefits of sitting in the back seat, we've educated parents about frontal airbags and improved belt fit in booster seats. But there's still more work to do.
One way we've been trying to make it easier for parents to install child restraints is to improve the latch system. Latch stands for lower anchors and tethers for children. We've done research with parent volunteers. We've validated those findings in real-world data at child safety seat checkpoints, and now we're rating vehicle latch systems.
14.2.
We don't stop at a study that says this will work to reduce injuries or deaths.
There's new information from parents trying to keep their children safe.
We figure out ways to communicate our findings so that they make a difference in the real world. The Institute did some of the seminal research identifying the risk for teenage drivers. But we didn't stop there. We then were involved in identifying a very important countermeasure, graduated licensing laws. And then we evaluated those laws. And today, we know that our research has been a big part of keeping teenagers safer.
The insurance industry today put out a list of recommended used cars for teenagers.
Teenagers are driving those smaller, cheaper cars, so now the Institute has compiled a list.
Our goal at the Institute is to prevent crashes and save lives. and our research has really helped make that happen.